in here. President Trump and Melania Trump arriving at the Opera House in Buenos Aires, Argentina, for a wonderful evening of entertainment and meeting and greeting. Sometimes what gets done in the hallways actually exceeds what's done in the round tables where they're supposed to discuss things. But that's the First Lady of Argentina that he's kissing there, and of course the President of Argentina. They are arriving amid a lot of things that are going on involving trade in the United States, not only with China, which is the focus of the dinner tomorrow night with President Xi, but also today with the formerly NAFTA treaty, now called the USMCA, between Mexico and Canada and the United States. The problem with that, of course, as we'll discuss later, is it has to go through Congress. Where it could get stuck because of a lot of bipartisan wrangling over what should be in it. There is the official photograph of the president along with the president of Argentina. He is there, I believe he will be leaving on Sunday after his Saturday night dinner. But go ahead, Foster, as we're watching the president, you want to talk about Ocasio-Cortez. Go ahead.
Well, the Lord has blessed me with a lot of success, because I looked at people not so much on their past or where they are today, but what they can become. And I'm absolutely very impressed with this woman. She's bright, she's articulate, she has energy, she has passion. I think she has a good heart. And I think if she could be put on this committee very quickly, she would learn the power of capitalism, how we've taken so many people out of poverty, how we have so much freedom, the ability to decide if we want to buy a McDonald's or buy a Wendy's. All these things are so important in capitalism. And I think maybe one of the first things, the whole Financial Services Committee ought to get on a plane and go down to see Venezuela to see how socialism really works, and
and
watch the people eat.
Well,
they're eating their dogs.
I'm going to link it back then to the pictures that we're seeing from Buenos Aires, Argentina, and President Trump and Melania. They're in that beautiful opera house. You know, I believe that the U.S. is probably the premier place to put your money. I think a lot of investors agree with that at this point. That does have to do with recovery in the banking sector as well. And if you want to put Ocasio-Cortez on this House banking panel in the future, along with Maxine Waters, I'm not sure that's going to make American banks as competitive in a rising rate environment.
Foster, I actually like your optimism about, but I'm not sure this is the place for her to learn on the job about how banking works. I mean, I do like, there's some good qualities of this woman, there's no question about it, but this is a very complicated job. And on an upside, she hasn't been corrupted yet by all the donations that come to New York area politicians from the banking industry. But, like, you know, even like Barney Frank, who was like definitely very far left, did the Dodd-Frank, he understood, I think, the whole banking system and financial services. You might not agree with his politics, but I think there's a lack of experience and education coming with some of these people coming into government, even though they're young and everything. They don't have MBAs. They haven't worked in bank. I don't think they understand the business enough to.
But remember, it's about politics, and this not only will give her more exposure, but they may want some of that to bring exposure to a committee. This is also, by the way, a committee that's going to be looking into Donald Trump's finances. So they're going to want as much attention, the Democrats are, to this committee as possible. And because she is a rising star, like her policies or not, she is a rising star. I think that's one reason they might want to put her on the committee, even though she's only 29.
Two key initiatives, David. I think you're right. The first thing they'll demand is President Trump's tax returns, or try and demand it. We'll see how far that goes. And the second thing is both her Ocasio-Cortez and Maxine Waters want more affordable housing. So I think that will also be a key initiative. But at least initially, if this plays out where she has a seat on the committee, I don't think it'll be bad for banks initially if they focus on President Trump's tax return and affordable housing. Thank God.
Okay, let's get back to the pictures then. And at the G20 Buenos Aires.